youth of today, what do they think they're up to? Wasn't like that in my day. Yes, when I was a teenager, the ancient Buttercross here in Winchester High Street was a magnet for young people with gel in their hair, a sneer on their lips, and resentment in their hearts. And I was among them. I'm not going to pretend I was some anarchist looking to tear down the establishment, but I've returned to my old haunt with a question. Is the teen rebel a dying breed? Overload. I know. What about the gangs of yobs, the binge drinkers, the riots? I'm not saying everything's perfect, but bear with me. Sex, drugs, booze, fags, crime. When it comes to problems with these, the stats show things are better than they've been in years. Take smoking among teens, at its lowest level since records began. Alcohol, huge falls in consumption. Teenagers drink less than their parents. Young people's drug use has been falling for a decade. Teenage pregnancies at the lowest level ever recorded. And then there's crime. Public concern about youth nuisance has fallen dramatically, and the number of youngsters getting into trouble with the police has halved in 5 years. So what's going on? I've returned to my old school, Peter Simmons, now one of the largest sixth form colleges in Britain, to show some of the 3,500 young people who come here how teenagers are often expected to behave. People try to put us to death. It was about young people saying that they had a stake in society, they had a voice. Since the 50s, young people have defined themselves in contrast to their parents' generation. Music and clothes were designed to shock, challenging establishment norms. But this lot say they've got other things on their mind.
I need to study rather than rebel. I need to study rather than be out doing other things that are stupid. So I'll sit inside and I'll do that, and then I might go out.
Working hard is cool. The persecuted SWAT of the 70s proudly displays geek chic credentials today. One of my old teachers retired only recently. He's watched the generations come and go, so does he reckon teenagers are less rebellious than in my day?
Yeah, I think they're much more chilled out, I think. There were a lot of sort of angry young people around, I think, in the 60s. I don't know whether it was their parents that stirred them up a bit or whatever, or just kicking against the traces, but no, I think you're right. I think they've kind of mellowed over the years, is my kind of impression, really.
Do you think they work harder these days?
Yeah, definitely. Definitely.
Harder than I was.
Much harder.
Work harder and play harder, too. At a student bop at Winchester Uni, I met up with Dr. Lucy Robinson, an expert on youth culture.
These are my parents! I love them!
Yep, one girl had indeed brought her parents to the club. Evidence of another explanation for teenage conformity.
For a lot of young people, they share the same musical taste as their parents. They might be going to the same concerts. They probably might be wearing the same clothes as their parents.
There's nothing to rebel against.
I think for a lot of young people there isn't anything to rebel against, and partly that tells us more about adulthood than it does about young people.
Young people inhabit a world of slip hazard warnings and branded retro fashion. Above all, keep us safe.
Well, capitalism just has won. We consume the same pop that people want us to consume. We eat what we're told to eat. We'll watch the advert and we'll do what we're told. It's like sort of advertising has made us into complete consumers. We don't question anything anymore.
Capitalism has also transformed that defining teen behaviour, hanging around. British youth has traditionally done lots of it, out with mates, having a crafty Benson's and a cider behind the bus shelter, getting up to mischief. But go to my old Winchester haunt and there's almost no one there anymore. Hanging around has become a virtual activity.
Hi, how are you?
Hello, I'm good, and you?
I'm good. How's everything?
Safi spends 2 or 3 hours a night on social media, Facebook, Twitter and Skype.
So it's really easy to keep in touch because everyone's online. Like, I feel like actually having a proper conversation with someone, even though you're, like, miles away from them. So, no, I do like it.
In another bedroom, Stuart puts the hours in online gaming. There's no time to be bored.
And you spend, what, 2 or 3 hours a day doing this kind of thing?
Yeah, probably. About that. It's easy.
Wow.
You know, if you're bored, it's fun just to play.
Victory! And you've won!
I've won, yeah.
So not only have you killed boredom, but you've killed enough people to win.
Yeah.
Technology means teenagers can meet friends and express themselves without ever having to step outside.
Social networking allows us to completely express our views and allows us to be heard, which is what the 1960s and 1970s was all about being heard. And I think it is that that has toned down the rebellious teenager generally.
In my day, it wasn't like this. Teenagers were outside, looking in, marginalised, bored, angry, an external threat. I'm not saying everything's fine now. Some youngsters will always present problems. But the tension between adolescent and adult worlds, youthful challenge to the establishment, is not what it was. And while there's much to welcome in that, part of me wonders if something has been lost.